The roadways in Durango are critical for travel, commerce, and tourism. All of it depends on the US 550 and US 160 corridors and this interchange of the two highways.
The current alignment of US 550 as it approaches the intersection with US 160 is steep, windy, and shaded, making the area icy and dangerous during the winter months.
CDOT, the City of Durango, La Plata County, and the Southern Ute Indian Tribe have been working together to upgrade the US 550 corridor as well as the US 550-160 interchange. It is through this partnership that the project has become a reality after years of effort.
After looking at the magnitude of the project needs and the limited funding to achieve them, it was apparent that we would need an innovative and refined design that blended into the natural topography.
We have five goals for the project, including maximize the project scope, quality design and construction, an integrated approach to the earthwork, enhanced corridor aesthetics, and working with a strong design build team. The Lawrence, RS&H, and CDOT team has worked together to solve the challenges of the project and to meet these goals.
Our strong relationship with RS&H and a long history of partnering with them on complex roadways gave us a lot of confidence that we were the right team for this project.
Our team took on this challenge with the goal of providing CDOT and the residents of Durango with a design that incorporated the full list of project requirements and additional requested elements, which included 3 additional miles of improvements, all within the project budget.
The new roadway crosses 2 deep gulches requiring bridges that will rise as much as 130 feet above the gulch bottom. Due to the rural location of the project and difficult steep terrain, we had to consider constructability challenges at every step of the design. Ultimately, we selected a bridge type that requires minimal on-site formwork for the bridge deck. This approach speeds up construction, saves costs, and provides a long-lasting quality bridge.
Sustainability played an important role in our approach. Instead of hauling away all of the old road to be thrown away, we were able to reuse most of it. Further, we were able to take advantage of the excavated material to produce our aggregates that will become the new road base. 72% of it, in fact, is being crushed on site with special machinery and reused for the new road and bridges. By repurposing what already exists on site, we will nearly eliminate any need to import new materials.
The design was able to reduce earthwork excavation by 45%. Which translated into significant cost savings and increased scope. It also meant we could substantially reduce the project's effect on the environment, lowering impacts to the mesa by 8.5 acres.
For the new roundabout and roadway to the south, the project required major earthwork removal and impact to the hillside. We analyzed many alternatives to reduce these impacts and ultimately incorporated a unique oval roundabout layout. This layout shifted the roadway as far from the hillside as practical and also prioritized the major north-south travel movement. A 20-foot-high retaining wall of similar aesthetic to other walls along US 160 was also added.
It's exciting to see this project come together. It'll make the roadway safer, it'll keep the wildlife off the roads but still give them safe passage. The improvements factor in future growth and needs, all with the minimum impact to the environment.
This project is a great example of planners, engineers, and contractors coming together in a thoughtful way to design and construct roadways. The resulting project complements the natural landscape and allows the movement of wildlife, all while enhancing safety and meeting the growing traffic demands of our community.
We are truly proud of this project. Working together with CDOT and the rest of our partner companies, we have come together and are building a new corridor that is both safer for the traveling public and the local wildlife. The design and construction repurposed existing materials, minimized environmental impacts, and enhanced the aesthetics. It will meet not only today's needs, as well as accommodate future capacity demands.